Hi there. This tutorial will show you how exactly I've been recording my Windows computer screen to a GIF file. An animated GIF file is as useful as a video explaining computer stuff to someone else. Still, it is much smaller than a video and very easy to share. I've been using this technique over and over to help my friends, cousins, and even tech support staff. I'm sure this technique will reduce your headache too. Without further jibber-jabber, let's start. So step 1 is to download ShareX, a small, free, and handy application with loads of screen recording functionalities. And that is because Windows does not come with a built-in GIF recorder. To download, go to getsharex.com/downloads. Click on the latest entry. In my case, it is ShareX 13.2.1. It will take you to a GitHub page. Click on the latest .exe file that you see there. Wait for the download to finish. It may take up to a few hours if you are on a dial-up connection. Once the download is complete, run the setup. Read and then accept the terms and conditions. My reading speed is pretty fast, so I'm just reading everything. And then I'll accept the agreement and click next. Now just uncheck everything in this box. You can then hit next and install. Hit finish. So ShareX should pop up automatically. If not, you can click on the start button, scroll down to ShareX, and click ShareX. Or the other simpler way is to click on your Windows search bar or the Cortana bar, type ShareX and click on it, and ShareX will open. Now what you need to do is recreate what you want to capture. It's just like a rehearsal before someone gives a shot for a movie. So right now, one of my friends is really frustrated as the time showing up on her computer is from her previous city of residence. I'll show her how to set the time zone to automatically adjust according to the place where she's visiting. I'll do a practice run first. So I click on date and time. I click set time zone automatically and sync now. So these are the exact steps that she needs to follow on her computer to get her issue resolved. Now that was a rehearsal, not the actual recording, so I'll close this window. So now we know that once we open the settings, it takes up this much part of the screen. So I'll just remember that. Less of the area that you want to capture, lower is the file size. Now the next step is to close ShareX. Don't worry, it will come up in your taskbar over here. And then you need to minimize all the programs. So right click on the ShareX icon over here, this multicolor icon. Go to capture and screen recording GIF. Then I'll select the area that I want to capture. I think it was from here till here. And the recording will start automatically. So I'll just recreate the steps. Click here, go to date and time settings, automatic, sync now. So I've recorded the steps that I want to share with my friend. I close the screen. Now I need to stop the recording. Try to keep the duration of the recording to less than a minute. for the file size to be acceptable, or otherwise it will be as big as a video. Now if for some reason the stop button is hidden, you can press and hold shift and print screen key on your keyboard to stop the recording, or I can simply go on the taskbar and I'll find this ShareX click to stop recording icon. I can just click on that and it will stop the recording. Now wait for ShareX to process the captured GIF file. Faster the computer, quicker the result. You can come back here to the taskbar and look at the progress. The small icon which resembles a video camera will show up here, and you will see the progress. Right now it's at 4%. What I'll do, I'll just speed up this part of the video so that you don't have to wait for that long for my slow computer to process this GIF file. You will get a notification on the right once the GIF file is ready. Click on the notification and you would see a preview of that GIF file. If it's all good to go, if you're satisfied with the result, yeah, seems fine. I'll close this. Yeah, once you're good to go, just click on the ShareX icon. You can double click on it and you'll get this window. So this latest entry on the top is the GIF file that we just recorded. Right click on that, click on open and click on folder. So this is the folder where the GIF file is recorded, and this file which is highlighted is the GIF in question. Now to make it simple for me to find this file, I'll just copy it and paste it on my desktop like other hundreds of files. And so what I can do with this file is I can email this file to her and she can simply open it on her computer and see the animation, or I can even WhatsApp it to her and that way she can look at the steps and do the same thing on her laptop. So this is how you can record a screen to a GIF in a minute or even less with a ShareX GIF recorder. So next time you want to explain a problem or share a solution, use GIF. It will make your life easier. Now sometimes the file size would be too large. Even if it's a GIF, the file size can go up if it's for a longer duration. Let me look at the file size for this particular GIF file. Right click, properties, and if you see here, this one is less than a megabyte. So it should be easy for me to share. Now in case if you record too many steps and the file size grows more than like 5 or 10 megabytes, then a few email providers might not allow you to send that large file. So what you can do is watch my next video. No, I'm not going to name those providers, but I'll show you how can you optimize those large GIF files to reduce their file size and make it easier for you to share. Do watch that video. I'll link it on the screen and in the description. If it is not uploaded yet, subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon to be notified once I upload that video and other helpful videos on YouTube. Please like and comment below if this tutorial was easy, average, or difficult. Your feedback will help me help you better. And most importantly, if you need any help on this topic, ask me through comments. Goodbye and see you in the next video.